Hey guys, we're back. I'm Issa.
And I'm Michelle.
And this is our after party. I'm so glad 2021 is over.
I don't know. I kind of miss it.
What? Why? Why would you miss that?
I don't know. Let's see what the public thinks.
What's going on? It's your boy Jonathan, back at it again in 2022 with our first after party video for the year. Today, you know, since in light of the new year, we're gonna ask a couple of people what their New Year's resolutions are, what their plans and goals are for this year, and without further ado, just get right into it. Here we have our first person today, Principal Fatou, and the question of the day is, what are your New Year's resolutions?
Okay. I'm going to step over here and take my mask off for a minute, all right? So thank you. Happy New Year, everybody. New Year's resolutions professionally is to be the best person I can to each and every student and staff member, be as kind as I can be. That's a daily thing that I like to carry forth. And personally, I like to kind of work out a little more, right? So I haven't worked out in a while, but I want to get back in shape and get back in the weight room.
Sounds great, guys. You know, be a better person. Show your pride. Go Bobcats. I'm here. You don't need to know me. It's fine. You don't need to know me. And today, question of today is, what are your New Year's resolutions? I don't think we can put them here with our next preview. Hey, come here, you. Hey, you.
What's up?
What's your New Year's resolution, sir?
New Year, new me, run for class president, sure.
He wants to be the president of the United States.
Quick picture.
I'm here with the future president of the United States. Thank you for your contributions, your future contributions.
Of course, man. I'll make sure to thank you and be my guest, all right?
Thank you so much.
Good meeting you.
Have an amazing day, guys. Hi. What is your name, ma'am?
Emma.
Luna. Okay, yeah. Emma Luna. What is your New Year's resolution?
To be nice to people.
Why? To be not.
Yeah.
Why is that?
You're really making me like question my New Year's resolution. Like, I don't want to be nice now.
But isn't that your New Year's resolution?
Yeah, but like, I don't want to do it anymore.
Wow, that's short lived. What day is it? Like day 10? Day 10, 11 of... It's day 10 of the new year, guys, and we've already... She's already lost to her new year conviction.
Sorry, guys.
You know, that's kind of mean.
Yeah.
I hope you seek help. I'm tired, bro. Excuse me, ma'am. See, ma'am, what are your New Year's resolutions?
I don't know. No, I don't want to...
What's your New Year's resolution?
I don't know.
You don't know?
No, not really. I have no. I don't know.
You sure you don't have a New Year's resolution?
I don't know. But are you gonna? No, I'm gonna leave right now.
You're gonna? Huh?
I hate. Come over. No, come over.
What? I'm. After that disturbing video, I hope to shed some light with some new New Year's resolutions. So, we have our first victim here. Excuse me, ma'am. Hi, what's your name?
Maddie.
Hi, Maddie. And what's your name, ma'am?
Nicolette.
That's a nice name. Anyway, what are your New Year's resolutions?
My New Year's resolutions, I would say, is to better myself and be kinder to the people around me.
Are you lying?
No.
Are you sure? And you?
Be the best version of myself I can be.
Period. I like that. Girl power. Thank you. I'm here with
Kyle.
Gio.
Kyle and Gio. What's y'all New Year's resolution, bro?
Get bread. Get your money up.
What exactly is bread, sir?
Just
Just like that, man. Just like that.
Just. Yeah. Insinuating.
Straight bread.
Okay. All right, y'all. I'm back it again inside the cafeteria, our new location. I'm here with these three suspecting children. They've run away. But I'm going to ask the first lady what her New Year's resolution is. So, ma'am, what's your name?
Lynn.
Lynn. Okay, her name is Lynn. Lynn, what is your New Year's resolution?
Yeah.
What is your New Year's resolution?
Good grades.
Why are you lying?
That's what you got to do. I mean, What do you want me to say?
Not be a cheater. Gotta be loyal for
him.
She's a cheater.
Wow. Okay, so I'm back again with my last people for today. Our question is, what is your New Year's resolution? So, affirmative action, go. I'm sorry. What are your names?
Oh, Alyssa, Jordan.
Okay, Alyssa and Jordan, guys. New Year's resolution, go.
I guess my New Year's resolution would be like better grades and like to try new things, go new places and stuff like that.
Go new places?
Yeah.
Elaborate.
Like, I don't know, like do more stuff with friends. Like when we go out, go to different places and places we've never been before and stuff like that.
During COVID?
Well, only the vaccinated friends.
Only the vaccine. Isn't that kind of like discriminatory though?
Sir.
Okay, and you?
Mine is to go new places, the same thing, but also meet new people and try to go be more out there.
You're going to be more out there during COVID?
With masks and safety regulations.
Get your booster.
Get your booster shots, people.
A booster ain't saving you. That's all I have for you guys today, Bobcats. Have an amazing rest of the year, and I'll see you next time.
You know, I'm going to take this new year to learn some new things. Me too. Speaking of new, I've heard of those new puppies in the vet program.
Aw, they're so cute, but what do they even learn in vet?
Let's ask.
Today I'm with my flamingo and we're gonna be asking animal facts. Yeah. You should probably walk.
Go. I feel calm,
bro. Oh, yeah. Okay, What do you think about animals?
What do you think about animals?
Yeah.
I like them.
You like?
I think they're pretty dope.
He likes them. Okay. Moving on. Yeah. Zoom in on this. Yeah. Keep rolling.
Zoom.
Yeah. How do you feel about the morality of eating that?
It's pretty funny.
Did you know that stonefish are the most poisonous fish in the world?
No. What is a stonefish?
What are you doing?
What is he doing?
Keep rolling.
What is he doing?
Look. Mom, say an animal fact. Huh? Go on.
Did you know that killer whales are... No. What are they called again? Killer whales, right?
I don't
orcas,
know.
Orcas are extremely smart and that they jump seals for fun.
Did you know that African elephants could be pregnant up to 2 years?
No, I didn't know that.
This
might as well happen.
Did you know that jaguars are fast?
What?
Did you know jaguars are fast?
Yeah. Jack.
Wow, I did not know that. That's very interesting.
Did you know that the duck-billed platypus does not have a stomach?
Ha. I didn't know that.
Did you know that anteaters eat up to 35,000 ants a day?
Huh? What?
That's it for our animal facts today. Tune in next week to see what we have next to make.
I mean, you'd think people would know more about animals.
I mean, I have stuffed animals.
Does that count?
So?
You're joking, right?
No, I am 100% serious.
There's no way you think robbing a house in your own neighborhood is a good idea.
Well, I'm not really robbing a house. We're just taking back what's mine. And it's not neighbor, it's Nora.
Who the hell is Nora?
Well, she's someone that bullied me back in elementary, you know?
So it's a personal thing?
No, It's more than just a personal thing, Noah.
What could it be inside that house that you're willing to plan a heist after all these years just to get it back? Is it something expensive?
No, it's a teddy bear.
What?
You heard me right. We're getting Mr. Fluffy back.
What the? You are insane.
No, I think the word you're looking for is genius.
Nope. I was right the first time. There's no way you're taking such a risk for such a stupid teddy bear.
It's not a teddy bear. It's Mr. Fluffy. When I was 5, I was running around the playground with Mr. Fluffy in my arms. And then Nora came, pushed me down. I scraped my knee and cried as I saw her run away with Mr. Fluffy.
Kids can be mean, but I'm sure she's changed.
Nope. She moved to my neighborhood a few months ago. Started with some random guy outside. She was all like, "You're dumb and stupid. I like your face. Blah, 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 blah."
I get that bullies are horrible and everything, but don't you think that this is a bit too extreme?
No, don't worry. I have the perfect plan.
Do you, though? To pull off a heist, you need a whole group of people.
No, don't worry. I already got the perfect crew.
Wait, really?
Yeah, don't worry. I've done my research.
Okay. So I can see you're pretty serious about this, then. What kind of research have you done?
Well, I've only just watched the movies.
Oh, so like those that are based on true stories?
No, the fictional ones, but that's besides the point. All I know is, we need a getaway driver.
How in the world are you gonna get a getaway driver? None of us are old enough to drive.
Not true. Eddie was born a year before all of us. In fact, he barely made it into our grade. And he just happened and got his license a few weeks ago.
So, he already has a car?
Yep, he has a car, and I'm pretty sure he's in love with it. He's all like,
"Don't worry, baby, I'm not gonna let anything happen to you."
Wait, hold on. Why do you guys even need a car in the first place? Doesn't she live right in your neighborhood? It's not like you guys are gonna be running away from the cops like your robbers in the movies.
True, but it looks cooler.
Wait.
Don't worry, all we need now is a hacker. Nora probably has a security system. Sort of didn't get rid of that.
Do you actually know somebody who can bypass all that?
I know everyone. And by everyone, I mean a girl I met 2 weeks ago. She walked up to me and she was all like, "Hey, dork, wanna join the coding club?" Nah, I'm not really into that stuff. Were you good at it? Yeah, I'm pretty much a master. I went to one coding club meetup and learned everything I needed to know.
So she's only attended the club once?
Yeah, but she wants to explain the difference between a cable and a charger. So I think she knows what she's talking about.
I don't think that's enough.
But wait, you haven't heard the best part.
Tell me, Jack, what's the best part?
I recruited Jimmy.
The guy who does the morning announcements?
The one and only. The cool part about Jimmy is...
Whoa, let me take over this flashback and introduce myself. My name's Jimmy, and the cool part about me is that my voice is as smooth as butter.
Wait, hold on. So what does he do?
Nothing. He's just a really cool voice and make everything sound a lot better.
Jack, please don't tell me that you're gonna involve me in this.
Don't worry. I was saving that for last.
Jack!
Hear me out. When I was 5, I remember this double-jointed kid in our class. And whenever he did his arm thing, Nora was so disgusted, she would proceed to vomit every time.
So what? You want me to be there just because I'm double-jointed as well?
Yeah. So if you ever get stuck and need a distraction, you could do your weird finger thing.
What, this?
Yeah, that'll work perfectly.
Listen, Jack, we've both been friends for a really long time, and I'm willing to help you out with anything whatsoever. But this is just going a bit too far, bro. I'm sorry.
Wait, come on. Come on, Noah. The plan's gonna work. It's gonna work. It's perfect plan, Noah. It's gonna work. It's gonna work.
You know an animal I hate?
What?
Skunks.
Aw, but I mean, they're kind of cute, though.
This video says otherwise.
Howdy, y'all. My name's Natalie, and I'm going to show you a lost recording of the war against Stinky Boy. Now, I know the tape has the word Blue's Clues on it, but trust me, this is not Blue's Clues. Oh, and also, I put a song over the tape to make the viewing experience more pleasurable. Anyway, the following footage may contain some imagery. Viewers may find cursed. You're walking in the woods. There's no one around you and your phone is dead.
out of the corner of your eyes, you spotted him.
Stinky boy.
He's following you, about 30 feet back. He gets down on all fours and brings into a sprint. He's gaining on you.
Stinky boy.
You're looking for your car, but you're all turned around. He's almost upon you now, and you can see he has an ugly face. My God, it's hideous. Running from your life from Stinky Boy. He's banishing a spoon, it's Stinky Boy. Lurking in the shadows. Scary skunk demon, Stinky Boy. Living in the woods, Stinky Boy. Bonking for sport, Stinky Boy. Scooping all the bodies. Actual demon, Stinky Boy. Now it's dark, and you seem to have lost him. But you're hopelessly lost yourself, stranded with a demon. You creep silently through the underbrush. Ah, in the distance, a small cottage with a light on. Hope! You move steadily towards it, but your leg! Ah! They lost balance! Standing up your legs.
Quiet, quiet.
Sneaking through the cottage.
Quiet, quiet.
Now you're on the doorstep. Sitting inside, Stinky Boy. Sharpening a spoon, Stinky Boy. But he doesn't hear you enter, Stinky Boy. You're sneaking up behind him. Strangling demon, Stinky Boy. Fighting for your life with Stinky Boy. Wrestling a spoon from Stinky Boy. Scooping till he passed out. Seek the last from Stinky Boy. You walked into the dark woods, proceeding what the heck you just witnessed. You've beaten Stinky Boy. Wait, he isn't dead. Stinky surprise, there's a spoon to your head. And death in his eyes, but you can do jujitsu. Body slam demon, Stinky Boy. Legendary fight with Stinky Boy. Normal Tuesday night for Stinky Boy. You try to swing a spoon at Stinky Boy, but your legs are very, very tired. He dodges every swipe. He parries to the left. You counter to the right. You catch him in the act. You bonk him with a spoon now. You have just defeated Stinky Boy. He yeets to the floor, expressionless. You fall to your knees and catch your breath. You're finally safe from Stinky Boy.
Hey Isa, do you know any other languages?
I know Spanish and Arabic.
Cap, you do not know Arabic.
I don't.
Hi, I'm Barbara, and I'm going to be going around West Broward asking people what Portuguese words mean in English. I'm here with...
Trevor.
Okay, Trevor, I'm going to ask you a word in Portuguese, and you're going to tell me what it means in English.
Got it.
Okay, janela.
Broccoli.
Wrong. Hi, I'm here with...
Eliza.
Okay, I'm going to ask you a word in Portuguese, and you're going to tell me what it means in English. Ready?
No.
Golfinho.
Golden.
Wrong. Hi, I'm here with...
King.
I'm going to ask you a word in Portuguese, and you're going to tell me what it means in English, okay?
All right.
Ready? Refrigerante.
I don't know what that means, but I'm going to see. Hey, how you doing?
No. Hi, I'm here with Naya. I'm going to be asking you a word in Portuguese, and you're going to tell me what it means in English.
Okay.
Torradeira.
Homework.
Hi, I'm here with
Genesis.
I'm going to be asking you a word in Portuguese, and you're going to tell me what it means in English.
Okay.
Gravata.
Gravity.
No. Hi, I'm here with
George.
I'm going to be asking you a word in Portuguese, and you're going to tell me what it means in English. Oculus.
Octopus.
No. Hi, I'm here with...
Ciro.
I'm going to say a word in Portuguese, and you're going to tell me what it means in English, okay?
Okay.
Brilho labial.
You're so caught.
And Kylie. I'm going to ask you a word in Portuguese, and you're going to tell me what it means in English. Rosa.
House.
Well, that's all the people I interviewed today. And in conclusion, nobody knows Portuguese.
The music on the radio has been pretty lame recently.
Yeah, we need new young artists.
Maybe these people are good enough.
Think it's stuff. So good, I just can't sing no more. Turn it down, turn it up. You everywhere I go.
We just talk a lot.
Yeah, I'm getting kind of tired of it.
People should start asking us the questions.
I agree.
Hey, what's up, West Broward? It's Camila, and today we're going to be doing a reverse man on the street. Let's go. All right, we're here with...
Robert Quinn.
Brian Sosa.
You guys want to do a reverse man on the street?
A reverse what?
So you want to do a reverse man on the street?
I'm sorry?
Do you want to do a reverse man on the street? That's basically when you just ask me questions instead.
Great, let's do it.
All right.
Favorite color?
Pink.
All right, hold on. I think something. A squared plus B squared equals C squared. What is that?
Formula?
Yeah, what formula is that?
That's a Pythagorean theorem.
Okay, she got it right.
We're here with
Roca.
All right, you want to do a reverse man on the street?
Sure.
All right, bet. Here. You have to ask me a question.
A question. Yeah. All right. What are your grades looking right now?
All right. They're decent. All right.
How all right? Like how? You got A's, B's, C's?
All A's and B's. You already know.
Nice.
Who's your favorite teacher?
Mr. Rivera.
Mr. Rivera. And you have such good shoe taste. Where do you get your shoes from?
My shoes? Goat. Shout out to Goat. And StockX.
Okay. Let's see, you're always looking so cute. Wear your outfits. Any inspo or anything?
Any inspo? Honestly, this is just an original flow. I can't really give
okay.
you
an inspo.
So basically, you're going to ask me questions instead of me asking you questions.
Just on the spot.
Yeah, so you just ask me questions. That's it.
All right. I'm here with...
Camila. All right, we're here with the number one dancer in Florida.
Yeah, you feel me? That's me, you know.
What's your name?
Malakash.
All right, you want to do a reverse man on the street?
No.
What do you want to do then?
I want to go home.
Damn, me too. All right, thank you.
I'm Elijah, and you're watching Disney Channel.
I can't wait for the weekend. I can finally relax. Let's see what this group's going to do.
This has been Michelle
and Issa
for the After Party. We'll see you guys next time.